Okay, my beloved, if you love truth, just touch that subscribe button so that truth will keep coming on your way every time. Remember, truth is life. Lies is death. Lying is death. Truth is life. If you love truth, just go ahead and touch that subscribe button. Okay, now I am talking to you now about something very important. I want to read Matthew, the book of John, chapter 10. John 10, verse 11. John 10, verse 11. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd gives his life for the sheep. But a hireling, he who is not the shepherd, one who does not own the sheep, sees the wolf coming and leaves the sheep and flees, and the wolf catches the sheep and scatters them. The hireling flees because he is a hireling and does not care about the sheep. I am the good shepherd, and I know my sheep and am known by my own. I read again for you to understand. He says, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd gives his life for the sheep. What's happening today? Are you the one giving your life as a child of God? Your pastor, is your pastor giving his life for you, or are you giving your life for your pastor? This is the question I want to ask you. This is the word of God. Jesus said this. Jesus said that I am the good shepherd. Jesus said, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd gives his life for the sheep. The reason why God chose David in the Bible is because when David was very little, very tender, God is watching David. David is taking care of the sheep, the animals of his father, in the bush, in the wilderness. When David took the sheep out for them to find a pasture where to feed, anytime a lion, a wild animal, show up, as little as he is, he will stand and begin to fight the wild animal. David will stand and begin to fight even a lion or a tiger, anyone that show, David is capable of defending the sheep. This is how it's supposed to be. God now looked down from heaven. God said, this is the one I want. Among all his brothers and all of them, he is the little among all of them, the last. But the ability to watch over the sheep, over the animals of his father, the power to defend them is in him. God looked and said, this one will be my shepherd. This one can take care of my sheep. This one can take care, can be king over the house of Israel, because this one possessed the authority to be a leader, the authority of a good shepherd. That's why God called David. God chose him and said, this is my king, this is my anointed king. And David go ahead and please God in all his ways, in every area. David is able to fight the enemy, enemy of Israel, enemy of God's children. David stand and he fought battles upon battle because he loved God's children. He loved God and he loved his children. Jesus came. Jesus said, I am the good shepherd. I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd gives his life for the sheep. Jesus came. Jesus gave his life for me and you. Be wise. But your pastors today, you are the one giving your life for your pastor. Can't you see that something is wrong? Just look at it. Your pastor is supposed to give his life for you. Your pastor is supposed to stand and fight the devil and demons that's after your life. Your pastor is supposed to stand by you. Anytime the enemy show up in the realm of the spirit, your pastor is supposed to always be there. Stand and get every devil and demons destroyed. How can they do that when they are serving what is tormenting you? How can your pastor fight for you? How can your father, how can your pastor, your bishop, or your prophet fight for you? They themselves, they are the one feeding, giving you as food to the devil and demons. That's why you are having a terrible dreams. You have been going to them for prayer, and they gave you prayer to do, and the attack was too much. They can never stand and join and get the evil down and get evil slaughtered because they are serving the devil. They are serving the enemy. They are serving the wolves and the lions and the tiger that is after your life to eat you up. So Jesus said this. Why is your pastors not giving their life to see you being somebody? Your pastor's supposed to stand and fight the enemy, and fight the devil, and fight the demons. But instead, when the enemy show, when the enemy come up, they will hide. And the enemy will take as many as they want and go away. And take as many as they want and go away. Because they are just there to make money. They are just there to make money out of you. I think it is time for you to be wise. They are like they are being hired. They are being hired to claim to be shepherd, but they are not shepherd. They are not a pastor. They are not bishop. They are not prophet. They are not from God. That's why whenever any problem come up, they hide. They don't show up. So you can see Jesus came. He said, "Where is the devil?" He combat with devil. He enter into hell because of me and you, a good shepherd, the lovely shepherd. He enter into hell. He fought the enemy. He fought the devil, and he delivered me and you from the mouth of lions, from the mouth of tiger, from the mouth of the evil ones. He delivered us, and he drew us out of problem into enjoyment. He drew me and you out of death into life. This is a good shepherd. Look at what's going on. Your pastors with bodyguard, how can you see them? How can somebody that is being surrounded with bodyguard deliver you and fight for you? When you see this, you know that your pastor is also in bondage. He's afraid. So why are you calling him daddy? Why are you calling him my shepherd? Why are you calling him my bishop? Why are you calling him my prophet? When you know that himself is in danger, he's running. He's running for his life because he knows that he's evil. That he's not a shepherd, a true shepherd. He's not a man of God. A man who claims to possess the Spirit of God supposed to stand and fight evil government, fight evil spirit, fight evil, fight devil. A man who claims to possess the power that he can command fire to fall down, supposed to look at the president and speak to and tell him the truth, like someone like Buhari. Your pastor supposed to look at him and tell him, "You are a bloodsucker. You are an evil president. You are an antichrist. You are the one that ordained Boko Haram. You are the one that ordained Frank Hesman. Supposed to look at his face and tell him and speak the truth to him and tell him, and he will not do anything. When you look at them, even in the Holy Spirit, the president or the Buhari or the other, they will look at the man and be afraid and know that this one possess a sword of power. When you are more than somebody, let me tell something. When you claim to possess the highest power or the highest spirit, every other spirit come and they search, when they go spiritually and search you and see that you possess the highest power, they go down. You are the one in charge, you are the president, you are the one in authority, you are the one that everything will be afraid of. Because when they try to touch you, they go spiritual. And when they see the highest spirit inside of you, they be afraid. Like me, what I'm talking now. If I do not possess that spirit, if I try to say something, they will get me down immediately. Because they will go spiritual and teach you a lesson. If you are talking and you don't know who you are, that Jesus you are calling is not in you. You can talk. You try, they will teach you a lesson.
The devil will exercise his power. All these occultic pastors and the evil men and the evil men that is calling themselves men of God, they will teach you lesson. If you are talking under your own authority or lesser power, they will teach you a lesson that you never forget. But why I'm talking is because try and see what will happen to you. One with the Spirit of Jesus is more than the whole world. Your pastor is being surrounded. So he surrounds himself with bodyguards. He cannot fight battle for you. He cannot fight the lions. Cannot fight the wolves. Cannot fight the tiger. Cannot fight the devil and demons, because he himself is in bondage. Is afraid. So stop going to somebody who is afraid to move around. Who is afraid to move freely. No, just know that person cannot help you. There's no help from that person. That person is also running for his life. He's afraid. He's living a fearful life. How can you be living a fearful life and come and deliver people? The Bible says, for God has not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of sound mind. So only somebody who is sound in the inside that can stand and fight for you. Only somebody who is free in the inside that can come out and set you free. Stop going to them. They are only putting you in bondage where they are. They are in bondage and they can never set you free. Jesus said, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd gives his life for the sheep. God bless you.